ever matched the fierce two-fisted warrior of the 1950s, Carmen Basilio. After 5 years of competition, he won the New York State welterweight title by outpointing Billy Graham. 2 years later, he gained the World Welterweight Championship by stopping Tony DeMarco in 12 rounds. Three battles with Johnny Saxon ended with a spectacular rubber match, which Carmen won by a KO in the second round. The high watermark, however, in Carmen's career came on September 23rd, 1957, the day he decisioned Sugar Ray Robinson and brought home the middleweight crown. No title had ever been won at such a high sacrifice in blood and sweat. With their contrasting styles, Carmen and Sugar Ray were classic opponents. Basilio would bore in fearlessly, taking Ray's best punches in order to get at him, while Robinson, all style and grace, danced about flicking stinging jabs and combinations.
The winner and new middleweight champion of the world, Carmen Basilio!
Carmen's career was meteoric over 14 years when there was a profusion of talent in his weight division. His unique brand of courage, his iron purpose and tenacity won him a large following of fans from upstate New York.
It's a winning streak of 13 straight. The last... Basilio pouring it on. Carmen is elated. Basilio here in the 12th round. Tony is in trouble. Basilio pouring it on. Carmen throwing left and right. A savage right puts DeMarco on the canvas. Moves in to end it. Left and right to the jaw, and the referee steps in and stops the fight. DeMarco is out. Basilio throwing kisses to the crowd. They're trying to revive Tony in his corner. A sensational knockout victory for the great welterweight champion, Carmen Basilio.
Abruzzi, Italy, weighing 265 pounds, Dynamite Dominic DiNucci. And his partner from Niagara Falls, Canada, weighing 218 pounds, Tony Cannonball Parisi. That's it! The winner of the match, Dominic DiNucci and Tony Parisi!
From Toronto, Ontario, weighing 238, Billy Red Lion!
Billy Red Lions and Hurricane Smith come to grips. It's hard to tell who's got the wrist lock, but Billy Red took him down. A wing takedown. Pulls him down. Look out, Billy Red. Oh, man. He took him with a tackle. Here we go. Oh, look out. Got him hung up. Pulling him through. Oh, that hurt. Here we go. Alley up. Ready. The count. One, two, three. It's all over. The winner is Billy Red Lion.
This next man was a football star with the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Longtime favorite in both Canada and the States, Angelo King Kong Mosca.
Had a really strong scrap last night with Watery Cummins.
Told the linesman to stay away.
He does that all the time. I think he tries to wear the man out. But PJ's tough. PJ's had a good... Well, Barnaby comes back. Both middleweights, huh? About the same size. PJ with a couple there.
PJ says his mom still upset with him, wants him to score some goals and not fight as much.
You can't help but like PJ Sock. He's a good kid, isn't he? Barnaby last night, he's shaking his head. Let us go. He's two middleweights, so they're about the eighth round now.
Looks like they're collecting themselves for another flurry. Look at this.
No, wait, wait. She's... Barnaby with a couple of short ones. There go the lefts and the rights, and they still stay on their feet, Sam. Okay, I'm tired. Tell you, PJ's tough, and Barnaby's, he's hanging right in there, isn't he?
I don't know if that last roundhouse landed.
Here, look at this. Oxygen, call the oxygen. Now Barnaby wants to go. I think he feels that PJ may be worn out now. I don't know.
Whoa. The linesman had enough.
Okay, I'm tired.
Playfair's been out after having reconstructive surgery of the knee. They weren't expecting him back until maybe February at the earliest, and they wouldn't have been surprised if he was gone all season. But here he is, and Linden's doing all right against the well-known and long-standing tough guy.
He's just a tough guy, both of them, Linden Byers.
But Homer gave a good shot. Oh, Homer's really getting some right hands on Playfair. Playfair hasn't been able to throw a punch yet. Holman still down and getting away. Playfair still trying to throw some right hands or left hands, and he couldn't get anything loose. As Holman had a pretty good hold on him and landed some about four or five excellent right hands at him. But Holman went at Playfair, gave him a good shot at about the first shift on the ice.
Oh, Dave Hutchinson and Buffalo rookie Playfair are now the main eventers.
Playfair's from Portland, a real tough kid.
And up comes Playfair's sweater over his head. Hutchison gets that right hand free. The linesman had hold of the other two, so Brian Lewis, the only man able to try and stop that. Now one of the linesmen comes back, and he will now try and separate Playfair and Dave Hutchison. You saw that one before either.
But now Pro being 35, he has to kind of pick his spots.
Oh, here we go. The big Playfair with Coxopoulos. Now nobody wants to take on Playfair in the National Hockey League. And here's why.
So with Ty Domi and Rob Ray, the heavyweight bout just getting underway. And the fists are flying. Look at Rob Ray coming in with the hard right. Domi's just hanging on. Ray with those heavy cylinders. He'll torque it up now, folks. Rob Ray and Ty Domi letting it go. And Ray has put in a few stingers, Jim Lorenz.
Ty Domi and Rob Ray now as fights go. This was a pretty good one. Domi gets the best of Ray early on, but the little scrapper, number 32, comes back and gets the bald-headed wonder with a few right-handed haymakers. And we'll give this decision to Ray and give the Sabres the decision. 2-1, Grant Fuhr, 22 saves. Sabres snap their five-game skid. How about it, Alex?
Rob Ray's got the magic uniform that comes off with one pull. When he retires from hockey, he picks it a job with the Chippendale Dancers. And here's the fight right now. These punches by Ray in the back of the helmet look dangerous, but really aren't. There's his physique. There's his smile, and he's going to the room, and there's Domi, who's waving goodbye to him. Rob Ray's got the magic uniform. He really has. One tug, and it's all off. Shoulder pads, elbow pads, gloves, and sweater. And you can see long underwear is not part of his equipment. Well, Domi gets a big kick out of this. They both do. 0-4. I guess they fought four times, and Rob Ray is trying to tell Domi that he's 0-4 in fights against him.
Ray, ready to go with Domi. Ray and Domi are going to get it on over in front of the penalty box, and Ray hammering away at Domi, but Domi pops right back up onto his feet. He starts firing, punches back again, and now Domi gets in. Now here comes Ray, and Domi trying to hold him off. Ray jams him into the boards, trying to catch up with him. Now he's got him behind. Now they start firing. Again, the officials just standing back and letting them go. Oh, and now Ray smacks Domi with another right, and the linesmen get in there to break me. Hodgers and Ray are ready to whip at center ice. Jeff Hodgers and Rob Ray are exchanging blows, and now Hodgers take one. Who displays. There you go! Ray and Domi firing punches away! How many times have they done this? Domi got Ray's sweater up over his head! Now Domi lost his helmet. Ray, I believe, still has his arm, but Domi's got firing punches. Ray trying to come back, trying to get the sweater off his head so he can start tossing punches back again. Finally he does! Now he starts coming away! Coming away with the right! Ray and Domi spooking each other with the punches. Now they hang on and the linesman hit him there!
And even the guys fighting have to stop and take a peek at this one. They just stop when they see some fan go at the Sabres bench, and Rob Ray gives them what for. Today, Rob tells us what happened.
Well, this guy sort of sat up there, and he just sort of sat on top of the glass, and he never really said anything. He just sort of sat there, and he stared, and he looked around, and he stared, and, you know, we're kind of wondering, what's this guy going to do? So, you know, we weren't going to really wait to give him the chance of, you know, who knows what he's going to do, you know, all the things that happened. So, you know, as soon as he jumped, we sort of just threw him up, and, you know, hopefully that was going to be the end, but he came right back. So, and then that's when we sort of took a little force to him and tried to slow him down or tried to get him out of there. And, you know, by that time, the police had come and they took him away.